Whether it's the loud echo of the waters or the whisper of the wind in your ears, you cannot help but wonder, how does sound travel in water and air? When underwater, water might be blocking your ears, but still, you can hear every wave, the sound of fishes swimming near you, and your breathing. And when you're up in the air, even before your parachute opens and the wind calms, you can still hear yourself screaming. In today's episode of Science Curiosities, we will explain how sound travels in water and the air. But before we discuss that, don't forget to subscribe to the Science Times YouTube channel so you will always be notified when we upload a new video. Let's get into it! Regarding the speed of sound in solids, liquids, and gases, there is no defining term for what it is. According to an article, there is no such thing as the speed of sound. There is no defining term for the speed of sound because it varies from one medium to another. First, let us answer, does sound travel faster in the air or water? The answer is the latter. Sound travels faster in water and any form of liquids than gases or air. Sound is the energy circulated through pressure waves that can travel in solids, liquids, and gases, but its speed will not always be at the same rate. It heavily depends on the specific solid, liquid, and gas properties. It is a vibration of kinetic energy that executes a domino effect, passing it from one molecule to another until our ears receive it, then signals to our brain that we are hearing a sound. Passing a vibration also acts as a relay race, where the first receiving molecule runs to the nearest molecule, where he passes the vibration. This goes on until all particles present receive the kinetic energy. All of these will happen very fast, especially if the molecules are closer to each other or if it is a denser material, like a solid. The more compact the molecules inside a material are, the faster the vibration or the kinetic energy can travel out, and the quicker a person can analyze the incoming sound. According to Woodford, a sound has two different aspects. The first is the physical process, transforming the kinetic energy into sound, and the psychological process, which is the part where our ears hear the sound, signaling our brain, interpreting it as noise, speech, or music. When a person hears a sound coming from a solid and liquid simultaneously, he will hear the sound coming from a solid first. But with the sound between a liquid and a gas, as liquids are much denser than gases, he will hear the sound coming from the liquid first. The denser the material, the faster sound can travel, because water is a liquid with much denser particles than air, whereas gaseous molecules are the farthest apart in the three states of matter, vibrations pass much faster. Even though there is little resistance in gaseous molecules, the sound still cannot travel fast as it will take some time to bump into each other. While in liquid, although there is some resistance, the sound can travel fast as molecules are much closer to each other, and once the domino effect starts, it can easily continue. The speed of sound in water is around 3,243 miles per hour, which is 4 times faster than the speed of sound in air, about 767 miles per hour. More than that, the physical characteristics of liquid and gas play a massive role in defining the speed of the sound. There is salinity, density, temperature, and pressure in the water. The saltier the liquid is, the faster the sound can travel. The denser the water, the faster the sound. But the colder the water, the slower the sound. While in air, temperature, air direction, and humidity are factors in determining the travel speed of sound. In temperature, it was the same with water. The sound travels much faster with hotter air because the molecules are active. It also depends if the sound is coming from higher ground. And humidity, where the higher the water vapor, the faster the travel speed of sound. The speed of sound depends on all of these factors. It can also vary from time to time. Yes, we can hear every sound floating in the air. Even so, sound will always travel faster in the waters, even if everything is muffled. Want more videos about topics like this? Give this episode a thumbs up and comment below what you want us to discuss next. Subscribe to the Science Times YouTube channel to feed your curiosity with facts about everything science.